Liao Chengting has a lot to prove here. Without Zhuang Zhiyuan in the mix, he seems like a likely third spot for the team. That has been the case in other team events. Portugal will be coming up at the beginning of next year. Start things off before the World Tour. Good pressure. Now, in terms of the size advantage or disadvantage, one thing I was starting to talk about, better wingspan, but bigger middle to cover. Takes a little bit longer to recover from your strokes.
1-3.
It's one thing that makes Lin Wenru so dangerous is how smooth he is and how quick he is to recover. But Timo with outstanding and magical touch. Right down the line, quick change to cover the middle plays, the forehand to the short side for the win. Made that look quite easy, just like Lin Wenru made catching the ball on his forehand look easy. Good placement, wide out to Timo's forehand. Lefty-righty combo on both sides, so looking for that early wide placement to get the players to cross over. Can be effective. Top edge of the racket for Liao Chengting, a 5-2 lead for the German pair. Despite coming in a little bit late, Franziska still with a good touch.
2-6.
Able to keep pressure on the opponents. Now the winner of this match will be playing the winner of Liang Jingquan, Lin Gaoyuan versus Fan Zhendong and Xu Xin.
Let 2-6.
Timo and Franz right now up by 5. In the touch game, keeping it low enough in near the net. Again, that Chiquita of Lin Wenru can be dangerous, but if he crosses over too much, it leaves a big hole on the other side of the table.
9-2.
What an angle here, Franziska. Wide out to the forehand side of Liao Chengting. Whenever there's an opportunity to go wide to either forehand. Sides will be looking for it. But the danger of that wide wingspan, Franziska, one of the tallest players in the game right now, probably just behind Matthias Falk. 8 game points for the German pair. Chop block goes long, and the Deutschland duo take it 11-2. Domination in game number 1. Players back for game 2, Franz to start it off.
Love 1.
Better pressure this time around, already taking the first point. The Taiwanese 2.
2-love.
And right into the middle, jamming up Timo. Getting him to use the backhand from right in front of the elbow. A nice soft spinny shot. Liao Chengting sees Franz a little bit behind the table, doesn't go for the kill shot.
Love 4.
Well, would you believe it? Doubling their score without dropping a point from the first order of play, game number 1.
Love
quick over the table, Lin Wenru continuing. Nice fake here, the fading sliding flick. Maybe more of a long push just going under the ball, but watch how quick this is. For me, that's a liner. Either way, it's aggressive enough. I'm gonna go flick. Ice cream cone flick from Franz as he brushes across the ball, leaving it wide on the forehand side. On top of the bounce, Franz right there. Doing a good job of staying close to the table. Again, it's a natural inclination when you're a bit bigger to give yourself space. A little indecision there. calling the serve. Not an easy third ball. Lin Minru still making an outstanding shot. And once again, Liao Chengting there to finish. Extra rotation coming in from T-Mobile. Rogue Roscoff in the corner. Doubles world champion himself with Stefan Fetzner in 1989. The shorter side, Lin Minru changing up his placement with that opening receive. That backhand, so much wrist. The world has had trouble with it for a few years now. Spin from under the table. France bringing it back within three. The German pair dominated game number one and have been chasing from quite a hole in game number two.
Five, seven.
Inside the table, Franziska right there to capitalize on the net ball before. Not a bad recovery from Liao Chengting. Quite a good one, really, right near the line. Franziska making a very impressive shot. Some expression from Lin Minru. A bit surprised this ball didn't come into play, looking down at the racket. Taking the ball a little bit late, heavy rotation. T-Mobile able to generate so much spin. The timeout for the Chinese Taipei team. His reverse pendulum serves very strong. Looks like he's going pendulum, though.
Okay.
Sure enough, pendulum serve inside the table. A little bit of float, not too heavy of spin. And it's tied right back up, the Deutschland duo. German pair on the receive, tied up at 7 points apiece. Perfect placement on the parallel. Lin Minru right down the line. So 1 point lead back for the Taiwanese two. And the angle here, the wide forehand exploited. I just saw a very charming moment from Fang Zhendong. Well, he's very focused in general and people are screaming his name. He stopped to sign an autograph for a fan here. In the middle of everything. Right off the bounce again. It takes four out here for a rally like this. Liao Chengting from behind the table and on top of the bounce, the silent assassin. 3 game points to tie up the score. On the run, Liao Chengting with a big shot, but Franziska using the wingspan to cover the opposite side. Gets out quickly, saves game point. Man, was that a tough shot coming in. Head scratch moment. Just a moment. There's only proof that one of them is speaking right now. And the placement from Lin Minru, a Timo waiting on the other side, still manages to escape and take the points. Serving here to Timo. Quick and aggressive, moving forward on this ball. Franziska driving for the point.
Come on.
The bending backhand out wide. Once again, that backhand, we saw it against Fang Zhendong earlier this year. And of course, Matthias Falk as well.
One.
A quick apology to the teammate, T-Mobile. Timo's calling for a review, but it was just
T-Mobile
a warning.
Request for service height.
It's unfortunate for Timo and the Germans, but still, the swag points from that successful call on a warning nonetheless. He says, wait, hold it back for a minute. I don't want this to eventually become a fault. I'm pretty confident my toss was fine.
3-2.
The outcome of the match will be more important in many ways, but that for me is such a highlight moment already of today. Beautiful counter from Timo. The angle out wide to the forehand side. I think Rossi is still trying to hold back the smile from the successful challenge. That's how it goes. In any sport with a challenge system, players obviously know the game quite well. They're playing it for years and years. Endless hours during the week.
4-3.
So from time to time, they're going to get something right. I think that could have been worded better, meaning sometimes they're going to make successful calls and the umpire is going to be wrong. Good placement deep into the backhand corner. Timo putting the pressure on. Idea from Timo. Lin Minru starts to turn the corner. Timo goes the other way. Oh, just missing on the backhand counter. And a forehead slap from Patrick Fonzisk after a good sky lob here from Timo. Barely any movement. See where he was going. Arcs the ball. Looks like it goes wild. But the truth is, it didn't miss by that much in the end because of the heavy topspin on Franz's shot. To get Lin Minru to play a passive receive. Very tight serve from Timo that immediately puts pressure on Liao Chengting to surprise the opponents. Timo right there waiting, short stroke to the other side. This is where Timo and Lin Minru both really excel in their placement, their sense of the opponent. Another tight serve, a bit in towards the middle of the table here, near the line. Now, score line right now. Again, there's been a lot of entertainment throughout this match, but remember, the Taiwanese two were dominated in game one.
Come on!
Franz with good pressure on the backhand side, cross court. I only bring that up because right now, just 1 point between them in a tied up match here in game number three. Heavy spin from Timo right at the back of the table. 2 point lead for the Deutschland duo. And a good flick from Timo. Ice cream cone flick comes across the ball, bends it into the backhand corner, and now 3 game points. For Germany's Timo Boll and Patrick Franziska. A battle of feelings, so much side spin throughout, chops, pushes, and everything else, a dance around the table. So Timo Boar, as he's known here in China, with the serve.
One love.
Good parallel forehand. I was just thinking to myself, what's the difference between the top players on the court right now and world rank number 111, 23-year-old Liao Chengting? And I think flexibility in the wrist, patience, and the ability to improvise and change up angles.
One, two.
Even in the counter game, the blocking game, that every shot seems very intentional as opposed to reactive. Here, right into the body of France, gets a punch back.
Two,
a tight underspin serve, Liao Chengting for the outright point.
Three, two.
Now, interestingly enough, I think it was the mixed doubles, France, I forgot who they were playing, said, person apologized before the point was over. Now here, that's also what seemed to happen. Natural reaction. Right back down the line. Ling Minru on top of the bounce. In that situation with France, though, the point was actually given to the French. Someone was speaking in the middle of the point. Now, it wasn't intentional. That's going to be a judgment call on the umpire every time, I think. But fair enough. But if anyone were going to bring it up with an umpire, that would involve the silent assassin speaking.
Let you serve, now to serve.
No, then serve.
Players agree, Lin Minru, second serve here.
Oh. 4-3.
Excuse me, first serve rather. The warning was Liao Chengting should be serving. The player saying, no, it's all good. We've got it right.
Come on.
A good drive here from just behind the table. France with the power. Push for a late reaction. Franziska changes his mind, realizes he can't keep it short, so goes long with the push. A good placement here. This is what I was talking about earlier. Liao Chengting bringing a dose of this quick improvisation, as we say in English. My third language, no, anyway, right down the line to tie it up. It's 5 points apiece. And on the move, Lin Minru finds the wide angle. Again, that agility and surprise factor so high. As smooth as can be, it looks like he's gonna slide under the ball, but goes the other way with the forehand flick kill, the silent assassin. Now putting his team up to Taiwanese 2-2. Both feet in the air at the point of contact. Thing of beauty, that flip kill. Nice parallel. Liao Chengting on the parallel has been much more effective this game than he had been with the cross-court shots throughout. Zhang Penglong watching on. Zhang Penglong, formerly world number 3. Top player in Taiwan for some time before Zhuang Zhiyuan ended up taking that spot over. Right down the line, Liao Chengting again, the parallel shots. priceless so far for him. 5 game points, quite a turnaround from 5 each, 5 in a row. And now the cross-court wide angle. Liao Chengting really turning it on here in this last game. Back for the decider, game number 5. Liao Chengting to start with the serve. Timo on the receive. As deep and wide as can be, Timo testing the step around. Lin Wenru. Quick counter on the backhand side from deep in the backhand corner. This time, no step around needed. The silent assassin delivering, tying it up at 1 point apiece. Franziska getting low as he has to make a shot like this. Now, spoiler alert, just in case. You'll want to go back and watch it either way, but Shuxin and Fan Zhendong waiting in the final for the winner of this match. Some spectacular points in their 3-0 sweep.
1-3.
A lot of time taken between points here. Often you'll hear a warning for that.
2-3.
Maybe that's just part of being a nice guy, or being nice guys, I should say. But both Liao Chengting and Lin Wenru, incredibly polite and quiet. I'm watching the umpire, just waiting to see if she's going to warn.
4-2.
Not so common that we see Liao Chengting chopping out here. Remember, this is the decider at the first towel break. The Deutschland duo up by 2. Didn't see what the apology was for, but must have been something to send Liao Chengting into a chop. Typically, he'd have a good backhand opportunity there. Just the way the ball glides and curves. As Lin Wenru hits that forehand, it's always a little bit different. Timo with the quick recovery. Liao Chengting trying to play the short side of the table. Interestingly enough, in a position like that, if he goes deep to the forehand, I feel like there's a little more predictability on the next ball to keep Lin Wenru in position. So players will switch sides of the table, and now it will be the opposite order where Timo would play to Liao Chengting. So now Patrick Franziska would receive. Liao Chengting serving to Patrick Franziska.
Liao to serve, Franziska to receive. Oh, wait. System. 3-5.
It's the digital system lagging a little bit. Chance for everyone to take a breath. Liao Chengting to serve. Quick reaction, Franziska on top of the bounce. Again, staying close to the table, a key ingredient to force fast reactions out of the opponents. Not just that, he accelerated on that. Gave it back with topspin deep. I feel like that needs subtitles. That facial expression, of course. The angle again, right on the white of the line. To hit it there is dangerous for so many reasons. I mean, Timo, he's going to have a really tough time reaching this. He can't afford to cross over. And even if he gets that ball, Franz has to circle behind him quickly to get in position.
6-5.
So the Taiwanese 2 back within 1 point. No timeout yet for the Germans. And a big forehand deep to the backhand corner to tie it up. 3 points in a row for the Taiwanese two. Lin Wenru has made headlines throughout Taiwan for the last year of his life, and not just Taiwan, but around the world. On the way back, Timo from the ground able to see the celebration as he gets back up. This is one you have to watch again. There was just too much happening in this. Cover goes to the ground, Liao Chengting around the net. And Lin Wenru almost gets it back to the other side of the table. You want to see it come down just to see what happens. The Deutschland duo with a spectacular finish here on that point. Or at least a spectacular point, I should say. Finishing successfully. Well calibrated to the spin, Liao Chengting driving it deep to the backhand once again. Seven points apiece. Serves with Timo. Good touch from Franz, leaves it inside the table. 1 point lead for the Deutschland duo. Serve-wise, in terms of keeping it cryptic and fancy, Timo looking old school with the signs. OG, I like it. Simple, new school in every other way. Inside the table, Liao Chengting getting stronger and stronger. Last game was all about the parallel and the counters, surprise placement. Here on the receive as well. He's really raised his level late in the game. Late in the match. Just long on the backhand, Liao Chengting, the Germans. 1 point in front on the receive nonetheless, so they will have the last two serve combination in this match. Heavy spin, and Lin Wenru ties it up. 9 points apiece, the Taiwanese two at the third towel break. Keeping it positive. What do you say to each other in these moments? I'm trying to think back. It's been a little while since I've been deep in a doubles competition. More singles than anything. I think just words of encouragement. Heavy spin from Timo with the back of the table. And he drives it home. Match point for the Deutschland duo. Spinny backhand does it. Lin Wenru saves match point. Sends this into deuce in the fifth. Two double semifinals in a row have gone to deuce in the fifth. Before in the women's, we were looking at world champions versus world number one. But when you've got Timo thinking deeply like that, you've done something right. Not the first time for Lin Wenru. After all, he was the Czech Open champion over Timo. The placement, Liao Chengting goes wide to the forehand and he disguises it well. There was no telegraphing where he was going as he came in over the table. Match point for the silent assassin in Liao Chengting on the receive. Ah, the soft hands, Liao Chengting. Ting and Lin Winru, the Taiwanese two, take it over the Deutschland duo, and they will move on to battle Fan Zhendong and Xu Xin in the final in front of the home crowd for the Chinese national team.